I've spent the past several years working on a project about coal and mountaintop removal, and I am by no means an expert on the story of the plan Puebla Panama. I spent a little bit of time in Mexico and Central America, but not doing the research for this project. And one of the things that we're pretty geeked out on in the way that these graphics work as a tool is that you don't have to be an expert in order to share and transmit these drawings. The goal is that the drawings actually enable us all to be storytellers. Our graphic is called Mesoamerica Resiste. We decided to name it after the good news stories in the story of the Plan Puebla Panama, not after the bad news infrastructure development project. And that's because we've gotten lots of feedback from our audiences over the years that we've done an excellent job illustrating the bad news of colonization and consumption and all the gnarly stuff that's going on in the world, but that it's incredibly important to tell resistance stories as well. So the way that we've laid out this illustration is actually as a two-sided image. It's a barn door triptych. But when we open up the graphic, as you can see just like this, what's revealed inside is twice as much good news as bad news. And even though this slide is difficult to see, what we see underneath all of this gnarly stuff is the ceiba tree, or the Mayan tree of life, that's got its trunk shooting up to the left here as a main axis in the drawing. And the ceiba tree has large buttress roots that are grabbing onto the ground all across the image. And everywhere that they are, they're creating these pockets where stories of resistance are happening. Plan Puebla Panama is a collection of different infrastructure development projects. And I think the key thing that we've come to understand about this story is that it's really a question of scale, right? The electricity that's being generated through these projects isn't for local consumption, it's being shipped north.
Oh.
Right? The highways that are being constructed here are in places where communities don't have access to automobiles. So clearly that infrastructure is not for local use. It's about transforming one of the most biologically diverse and significant places in the world, this isthmus of Central America. As we were saying before, our first graphic in the trilogy about globalization was called the FTAA. At the time that graphic was made, there was a huge push in the global justice movement to defeat the Free Trade Area of the Americas, the proposed expansion of NAFTA to include all 33 countries in the Western Hemisphere except for Cuba. Right? And it's a really big victory that the FTAA was defeated. It's a really good news story of people's movements rising up and coming together, and it's really, really powerful. And one of the reasons why we've taken on this project about the Plan Puebla Panama is because we know that the folks that had that agenda in the early 2000s didn't just pack up and go home and say, okay, you know, you keep the world, it's cool. That they're continuing to play out that agenda, but under different names and different guises, right? And the PPP is one of those. And so some of the characters that are kind of pulling the strings to enact this plan are the faceless institutions depicted in the corners of the Old World Explorer's map. So this is our conquistador character. So what are some details that we notice in this slide?
No head.
No head, faceless, right? What else?
He's a cash register.
Cha-ching.
And he's open, wide, and money is flowing.
Mm-hmm. Open, wide, money flowing. He's got this. I learned last night that this is called a ruff. This is a character that represents some of the financial institutions that are facilitating these development projects, right? Institutions like the World Bank, or in this case the Inter-American Development Bank or Regional Bank. You can see here that this character has puppet governments that are separating the taxpayer paper dolls from their money, right? And dropping it into the cash register belly, reminding us that very often it's actually taxpayer dollars that end up subsidizing these development projects in the end.